So in previous class, we have discussed about various types of flows generally occurs in channels, and also we have discussed some of the equations like Chagee's equation and Manning's equation. So today we are going to derive equation that is discharge through open channel by Chagee's formula. So this today we are going to derive. That is a discharge through open channel by Chagee's formula. Okay, so the Chagee's formula is generally used for open channel flow for calculating the velocity of flow in a channel. So once we get the velocity, and it is very easy to calculate the discharge because the discharge formula is what Q equal to A into V. So once we come to know what is the velocity of flow in a channel, then we can easily calculate the area of flow, which depends upon the shape of the channel cross section. Okay, so let us consider here a uniform flow of water in a channel. So assuming that the flow is uniform, you all know the definition of uniform flow. So as we discussed it previously, so here considering uniform flow of water in a channel. So as shown in this figure here, this is a channel longitudinal section drawn here. As the flow is uniform, it means the flow is uniform means the velocity, depth of flow, and area of flow will be constant for the given length of the channel. So considering section 1 and 2, let us consider section 1 and 2 here. So here, considering the uniform flow, this is the channel section taken, and let us draw the cross section of this channel here. So the cross section of channel could be like this. It could be of any shape. This is the free surface of water, and this is its boundary. Okay. So here let us consider section 1 and 2, section 1 and section 2. So between these two sections, a study is made. Okay. So and this channel has a bottom slope. A slope is it is taken as a I, or you may take it as a theta also, no problem. So theta also you may take, or you can here it is taken as a I, a bottom slope I. And also the weight of the liquid present in this section, or weight of the water present in this section, which is acting vertically down, it is taken as a W. Particular down, it is taken as a W. Okay, this is the weight of water present between the section 1-1 and 2-2. That weight is acting vertically down, and since the angle of this channel bottom is theta with horizontal, and if this is theta, or this you can take it as a I, this is I, and this also I by trigonometry. So it like this. This is the horizontal line, and this is the channel bottom. Okay, so what is this angle? What is this angle? Theta, or you can take it as I also. In this textbook, they are taken as I. So when the weight is acting vertically downward, it will be acting vertically downward like this. The weight, you can see all here, it is acting vertically downward, W. Okay, when this is I, so what is this angle?
90 degree.
90 degree. What is this angle now?
I.
What is this angle? What is this angle? When this is 90 minus I, what is this angle?
Opposite same
90
angle.
Minus.
90 minus I. Then when it is 90 minus I, see the component of weight is acting parallel to the channel bottom. Can you see this one? You all can see this one. Then if I draw that one parallel to this bottom, if I draw like this, you all can see, right? When I draw parallel to this, what is this angle now?
90 degree.
Right? No, not this one, sorry. This one. When I draw this one, this one. This component. W cos I it is. I hope you're understanding. This is W. Okay. Then what is this one? What is this angle now? Is it 90? This one. This angle. Is it 90? That green color, can you see the green color?
Yes, sir, 90
Yes,
degree.
90.
Yes.
90 degrees. Then what is this angle? I. Correct? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
That is the same here taken. When this angle is I here, this angle also I. I hope you understood, all of you, why it is taken I here. All of you understood? You can write in the chat box whether you understood or not. I have explained it here, how this angle comes here. Then, okay, shall I erase this one? Or you are taking this one? Shall I erase?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this one, just I'll erase this one. Okay. Now, so since we have taken this as a I, then here the weight is acting vertically down here. So when you resolve this weight, because the angle made by this vertical that is which is acting vertically down, the weight, the angle made here is I. Okay. When I resolve this one, this will be, you can write, this will be, what is this one? W, is
Cos
it
theta.
W cos theta cos I? Okay, here taking angle as I, and this will be W sine I. And W sine I is the along the direction of flow, correct?
Yes, sir.
So this is a driving force. This is a driving force. Because of this driving force, the water is flowing in this direction. This is called as a driving force. Okay. And this component is acting vertically down. Okay. So because of this driving force, the water is flowing in the channel. Hence, we call it as a gravity flow. Okay. This is called as a gravity flow. And let us take the L is the length of the channel here. The L is the length of the channel. And A is the area of flow. This is the area of flow taken. A is the area of flow, and I is the slope of the bed. Here I is considered slope of bed. In some of the textbook, it is been taken theta also. You can take theta also, no problem. If theta or I is equal to slope of the bed, then the V is the mean velocity of flow. Here V is taken as a mean velocity of flow of water, and P is the wetted perimeter of the cross section. You all know the definition of wetted perimeter. What is wetted perimeter? So this is a wetted perimeter. It is wetted perimeter. What is wetted perimeter?
Contact between liquid.
As contact with a liquid. Okay, how much length of the channel is contact with the liquid, that is called as a wetted perimeter. Then here F is taken as a frictional resistance. See, the frictional resistance per unit velocity per unit area means because of the friction here, the shear stresses will be present, and which will be acting opposite to the direction of flow because of the channel surface. So this flow may experience a resistance, that is called as a frictional resistance, which is acting per unit velocity per unit area. That F is taken as a frictional resistance per unit velocity per unit area, which is acting opposite to the direction of flow. Okay, frictional resistance. Then the weight of water between section 11 and 22. So let us take the weight of water between section 11 and 22. So how much weight is there between section 11 and 22? Liquid is held between section 11 and 22. The weight of this liquid is acting vertically downward. So you all know the definition of specific weight. Specific weight is what? Weight by volume. Then what is the formula for weight? Weight equal to specific weight into volume. Okay, then the same formula applied here. So here the weight equal to specific weight of water multiplied by the volume of water. So the specific weight is symbol is a small w, or you may take as a gamma also. So here it is taken as a w, and the volume formula is area into area multiplied by length. Area of this cross section multiplied by the length gives you the volume. So that is taken here, w into a into l. Then the component of w along the direction of flow, the component of W along the direction of flow is what? W sine I. So which is taken here. So W sine I, because already you have calculated W, that is the weight of the liquid held between a section 11 and 22. That weight you substitute here, WAL into sine I. Then the frictional resistance against the motion of water. Also, there is a frictional resistance which is acting against the motion of water that is to be taken. The frictional resistance is a small f multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the
velocity, because this frictional resistance, which is acting opposite to the direction of motion of fluid, that will be per unit velocity per unit wetted surface. Hence it is taken as F multiplied by the surface area of that is the wetted surface area multiplied by the velocity. Then here the power is taken as a N, and the value of N is found to be experimentally, this value of N is found to be experimentally equal to 2, and surface area is equal to P into L. Surface area, how will you calculate the surface area of the channel? The surface area will be the perimeter multiplied by the length. The perimeter of the channel multiplied by the length gives you the surface area. So that is P into L. Then the frictional resistance against the motion will be the small f, that is the frictional resistance per unit velocity per unit area, multiplied by that frictional resistance is acting over and wetted surface area. The surface area is a perimeter into length, P into L, into velocity square. Velocity square, here they are taken, it has a turbulent flow. Because of the turbulent flow, the value of N will be 2, the power of N, that is the value will be 2. Okay. Then the component of weight of water along the direction of flow. So there are some of the forces which cause the motion of fluid are the forces acting on water between the section 1-1 and 2-2 are listed here. What all the forces are acting between section 1-1 and 2-2. So you have to take the which all forces are acting between section 1-1 and 2-2. What are those forces? The forces here are component of weight of water along the direction of flow, component of weight of water along the direction of flow. Which is that component? Can anyone tell what is the component of weight of water acting along the direction of flow?
W sin I.
W sin I.
W sin I, correct. W sin I. That is the driving force. Because of that, the water is flowing. W sin I. Also, the frictional resistance against the flow of water. Already I calculated the frictional resistance here against the flow of water, that is acting opposite to the direction of motion. And also the pressure force at section 1-1 and pressure force at section 2-2. Means if you plot a pressure forces here, the pressure forces will be acting like this. So these are the pressure forces at section 1-1 and 2-2 like this. And here if you plot, the pressure forces will be like this, section 2. And hence, since this channel section is having a uniform flow, means the depth is remain same from section 1 to 2, the intensity of pressure acting at section 1 and 2 will be the same, and both will get cancel each other. Okay. So here, as the depth of water at section 1-1 and 2-2 are the same, the pressure forces on these two sections are the same and acting in the opposite directions. Hence, they are cancel each other. They cancel each other in case of uniform flow. So just recall the definition of uniform flow. In case of a uniform flow, as you know, the velocity of flow is constant. The velocity of flow is constant. That is the definition of uniform flow for a given length of the channel. Hence, there is no acceleration acting on the water, because acceleration is what? What is the definition of acceleration? It's a velocity by time. Correct? Huh? Yes or no? Acceleration is a velocity by time. Yes. Since the velocity is constant here, when there is no change in the velocity with respect to time, then the acceleration is also constant. Acceleration is also constant, or you can take it as a nil also. So hence there is no acceleration acting on the water because of what? Because the velocity of flow is constant. Hence the resultant force acting in the direction of flow must be zero. The resultant force acting in the direction of flow must be zero. Then the resolving all the forces which are acting along the direction of force. So you have to resolve all the forces which are acting along the direction of flow. If you are taking along the direction of flow, means if you are taking an x direction flow, sum of all the forces which are acting along the direction of x is to be taken as a zero. Then you have to list all the forces. What are the forces acting here? What is the, what all forces, can anyone tell? Along the direction of which force is acting?
Driving force.
Driving force, that is W sin I. Is it along the direction of flow, right?
Yes, sir.
Is it plus or minus sine?
Plus.
plus. Then what is the one more force which is acting?
Frictional resistance.
Exactly, frictional resistance, which is acting opposite to the direction of flow. That is to be taken here, opposite to the direction of flow. This is a frictional resistance. It is to be taken as a minus, which is equal to zero. Why it is equal to zero? Because we are considering this, the volume of water, whatever present here, this is in equilibrium position. Okay, equilibrium position. Then substitute here and simplify this one. Just to go on simplifying this one. So just I want the velocity of flow, because Chaji's equation, whatever we are deriving, it gives you the velocity. So just take this velocity term out and just rearrange the terms here. So when I am rearranging the term, I am getting W by F one term, A by P one term, and sine I one term. Okay, just check it out here. Is it correct? Just check it out. L get cancels. Just check it out, this term. Okay, then again further if you simplify, so when I want velocity term, it is will be a square root of W by F. W is the specific weight and F is a frictional resistance per unit velocity per unit wetted area, and again the square root of A by P into sine I. But you know the definition of A by P. What is this one, A by P? What is A by P? Is it hydraulic radius? As I explained in a previous class, cross sectional area divided by wetted perimeter gives you the hydraulic radius. It is represented as a M, or sometimes it is represented as a H also, hydraulic radius. Have you remembered this one in a previous class?
Yes, sir.
It is the ratio between the cross sectional area of flow divided by the wetted perimeter gives you the hydraulic radius, that is represented M, or in some of the textbook it is taken as a R also. So both are same, only you can take any symbol. Okay, here then M is what, hydraulic mean depth, is also called as a hydraulic mean depth or hydraulic radius. And also the Chaji has taken this one, so square root of W by F. So this term he has replaced and introduced one new term C, and he named it as a Chaji's constant. It is a dimensional term. It has a unit, and this W by square root of W by F, which he called as a C, and he named as a Chaji's constant. He kept his name only and Chaji's constant, and this depends upon the surface roughness of the channel. So the channel could be made up of a brick, made up of a concrete, made up of a any other material, or it could be a natural channel. And he has given some of the values for that surface of the channel, that is called as a Chaji's constant C. And later on, substituting all the values A by P and square root of W by F in the above equation, in this equation, the final equation he got as this one. And also again further he modified this equation, and what he has taken for the small value of I, what is I in this figure? What is I?
Angle
of what? What is this angle?
Angle of channel with respect to ground.
Correct. This is the channel bottom slope. Okay, just this side it is lifted up, this side it is a zero. Okay, just because of this slope the water is flowing, hence it has gained the gravity flow. Because of this slope only it is flowing under gravity, then that is called a slope of the bed. Since this angle is very very small, I hope you are getting my point, this slope is very very small, hence they have taken it as, they are taking it for a small values of I, sine I is nearly equal to tan I. So he has replaced the trigonometry function here, they are taken simply it as a I only, theta only, because it's very small. Hence instead of writing a sine I, they directly written it as a I only. In some of the textbook they are taken V equal to C root of, and this hydraulic radius they are calling as a R, and this bed slope they are taken as a SO or SB. Both are same only. I hope you understood this one, all of you. Whether you can take it as a I or M, or you can take it as a R as R or S, but R means hydraulic radius, M also hydraulic radius, I means the bed slope, S means the bed slope. Okay, in some of the textbook they are taken like this. Okay, Then once you get the velocity, you can easily get the discharge, yes or no? Because what is the formula for Q?
into V.
A into V. If you substitute in this formula, you will get the discharge equation. Okay, this is a discharge. Okay, this is very, very important for the examination point of view. Okay, either you can take this formula or you can write this one. Okay, this is the Chagee's equation of discharge through the channel. So generally, usually Chagee's equation means it's a velocity of flow equation only, but they're asking you calculate the discharge or derive the discharge formula by using the Chagee's. Means you have to get first the velocity formula, then you have to substitute in Q equal to A into V. Finally, you will be getting this formula. I hope you understood this derivation, all of you.
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubt, you can ask here. Anything if you are not understood, you can ask here. Just they have considered a channel section and considered uniform flow. Remember the uniform flow. When you are saying it as a uniform flow, it means the depth of flow, velocity of flow, discharge, everything constant. Okay. Anything you want to ask, you can ask here because this is very important. I'll write here. It's a very important derivation. You can expect in your internal. Discharge through open channel by Chagee's formula. Derive an equation for discharge through open channel by using the Chagee's formula. Any doubt?
Okay. And one more thing, wherever I am saying very important, these questions will be most likely questions for the main university exam. You can note it down. Okay. So these are the most likely questions you may expect in your main exam. Okay. These are very important questions. And coming to this, based on the Chagee's equations, so here what I solved, the Chagee's equation, this is very simple to remember. Just you draw the channel section like this. Consider the two sections 1-1 and 2-2. And when you're considering the section 1-1 and 2-2 like this, here I consider section 1-1 and 2-2. Just note it down on the weight of the liquid which is acting vertically downward and resolve that component along the direction of flow and vertically. Then just you go on resolving the forces. You'll get the answer. Then coming to the numericals here. So let us take the first numerical here. Take the first one here. I think it's visible to you all, right? Okay. Just write down, find the velocity of flow and the rate of flow. Find the velocity of flow and rate of flow of water through a rectangular channel. Through a rectangular channel of 6 meter wide and 3 meter deep. When it is running full, the channel is having a bed slope of 1 in 2000. Take Chagee's constant C as 55. So this is the problem given, and generally this type of problems will be asked for 8 to 10 marks. Here they are asking you to calculate what is the velocity of flow and rate of flow, and they given the cross-sectional that is a channel section, cross-section, that is a shape of the channel section is as a rectangle, and also the dimensions of the channel they are given. It is running full. Also they are given the bed slope of the channel. Okay, so here what you do, first you draw the channel section. So first you draw the channel section. What is the shape of the channel section? Rectangle. Like all of you draw first rectangle channel section. This is the channel. Okay, then this is the free surface support. What are the dimensions given here? What is the width given?
6 meter.
6 meter. Okay, 6 meter. You take it as a B. Then what is the depth of flow given?
3 meter.
3 meter. You can take it as a D or Y, whatever. Here they're taken as a D. In some of the textbook, they're taken as a Y also. Both are same only. You can take it as a Y or B. Okay. So here width is B, depth is 3 meter given, and also this channel, it is like this channel, and it has a slope like this. It has a slope with horizontal. It has a slope, and this slope, as I told in the previous class, it can be expressed in a degrees, or it can be expressed in a percentage, or it can be expressed in a fraction like this, 1 in 2000, like this. Okay, I hope you understood. Are you understanding what is given here? For
yes, sir.
1 in 2000 means for every 2000 meter run, one is the drop. Okay, so here let us write the given data here. The width of the channel section is given 6 meter. Depth of the channel section is given as a 3 meter. And calculate the area. Area will be 18 square meter. You also cross check it. You can use the calculator and just cross check. And the bed slope I, the bed slope is represented as I. I is given as 1 in 2000. It is written as a 1 in 2000. Chaji's constant is given in a problem. That is to be taken directly. That is given. And the perimeter, because I need to calculate the hydraulic radius. As you know the formula for hydraulic radius, what is hydraulic radius formula? M. It is represented as M because the Chaji's formula is what? V equal to C root of MI. MI. In this, C is given, but you need to calculate M. M equal to what? A by P. Already you have calculated the area. I need to calculate the perimeter. How will you calculate the perimeter here? Wetted perimeter I want. How will you calculate the wetted perimeter? This B is a wetted. Correct. B plus 2D. Correct. Is it wetted perimeter, right? You all can see the green line. This is wetted perimeter. Okay. Then wetted perimeter will be what? B plus 2D. It is given here. B plus 2D. Just calculate here. Then you will get this wetted perimeter. Then after that, hydraulic mean depth or hydraulic radius, you need to calculate M equal to A by P. This you will get. Then once you get these all parameters, substitute in the equation, this equation. Then that will be V equal to C root of MI. Then you will get the velocity of flow. Once you get the velocity of flow, then it is very easy to calculate the discharge. V Q equal to A into V. I hope you understood this problem. Very simple. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask here or else I'll go to the next problem. No doubt. Then coming to the next problem, similar type. Just I go on explaining the problems here. Try to understand problems here and you practice it later. So this is the problem. Find the slope of the bed. Here they are asking you find the slope of the bed of the rectangular channel. Again, they given the shape of the channel as a rectangular, and width is 5 meter when depth of water is 2 meter in that channel, and also the rate of flow is 20 meter cube per second. Here Q is given. Take Chaji's constant C as a 50. So here again the channel shape is rectangle. Channel shape is rectangle. What is the width given?
5 meter.
5 meter. Depth of water? 2 meter. Also, how much discharge is passing?
20 meter cube per second.
20 meter cube per second. So, these are the datas given here. With these datas, you have to calculate. The width of the channel is 5 meter. Depth is 2 meter. Q is 20 meter cube per second. Chaji's constant is given as a 50. Then, let the bed of the slope, bed slope should be I. I need to calculate I. So, you know the formula. That is V equal to C root of MI. This is the formula we are knowing. Also, Q equal to A into V. So, if I substitute Q, it will be A into C root of MI. Okay. So, in this formula, which is unknown, Q is given, right? And A is also given? Yes or no?
Yes.
Q is given, A is given. A means you have to calculate that A from the cross-sectional area, cross-section of the channel. C is given. And M equal to, how will you get M? A by P.
A by P.
Correct. Okay. Then calculate the area first, 5 into 2. Then the A equal to, M equal to A by P. And you know for a rectangular channel, wetted perimeter will be B plus 2D. Substitute that one, you will get the hydraulic radius. Then when you get all these data, substitute back in this formula. In this formula, you substitute. Then you will get the answer here. Okay. Then I want the bed slope of the channel. Just you check the answer. So please, all of you check this answer. I'll give 1 minute time. You have a calculator and all. Just check whether it is right or wrong. The answer. 1 in 694.44. Please check the answer, all of you. If you got same answer, you write in the chat comment box or any other answer. If you're getting that also, you write it.
Correct, sir.
Okay. Is this right? Right.
Right. Okay, this is the way how to solve the problem. So take one more problem on this Chajji's equation only. Okay, these all will be there for your IA. So these problems, similar kind of problem you will get in your IA. Okay, let us take this problem, the problem number 3. Just note it down here. A flow of water of 100 liters per second, 100 liters per second, flows down in a rectangular flume of width 600 millimeter and having an adjustable bottom slope. See, it's adjustable bottom slope. You can change the bottom slope. Means let us assume that this is a laboratory channel. So if Chajji's constant is 56, find the bottom slope necessary for uniform flow with a depth of flow of 300 millimeter. Also find the conveyance K of the flume. Please keep your audio mute. Hello. Please keep your audio mute. See, a flow of water of 100 liters per second flows down in a rectangular flume of width 600 millimeter and having an adjustable bottom slope. If Chajji's constant C is 56, find the bottom slope necessary for uniform flow with a depth of flow of 300 millimeter. Also find the conveyance of the flume. Okay, so again, same here, the rectangular channel only given, the same rectangular channel, write all the dimensions. Its width is 600 millimeter, then the depth is how much is the depth?
300.
Depth 300. Is 300. Correct, depth is 300. Depth is 300. And the given the discharge, 100 LPS liters per second. Convert it into meter cube per second. It is divided by 1000, 0.1 meter cube per second. Then the dimensions are given in a millimeter. Convert it into meter. Then calculate the area of flow. Then you will get B into D, because the area of rectangle is a width into depth, B into D. Then the Chajji's constant C is given, which is depending upon the roughness of the channel. Then let the slope of the bed be again I. The value of I is not given. That only they are asking you to calculate. Then calculate the hydraulic mean depth, that is M equal to A by P. And P is the wetted perimeter, A is the cross-sectional area of flow. Then the substitute the values here and get the hydraulic mean depth. Then you all know the equation Q equal to A into V. In that, you substitute the Chajji's equation. We will be getting Q equal to AC root of square root of M into I. Then all the data you know here, Q is given and A you have calculated, C is given, M you have calculated, and only left out is I. Calculate I here. Just check out this answer, whether this answer is right or wrong. Please check this answer, all of you. The slope you have calculated, just check out. Check the slope. All of you check the slope, what the answer we have got here. You just check it out, whether it is right or wrong. Is it correct? Just check it.
Sir, it's 1535.
You're getting. So the same answer you have got here, this one, just check it. It will vary sometimes. Okay, 1535 you're getting, right? You're getting one in?
Yes, sir.
1535. Okay, this also correct. No problem. This is also correct. Up to 1600 also answer is right. It may vary from person to person. How many digits you are considered after the decimal? It depends. Okay. So this also correct.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Even if you are getting 1 in 1550, that is also correct answer. Okay. Okay. So finally, you need to calculate the conveyance. Conveyance K. Here the symbol is K. What is this conveyance? Conveyance means it is the measure of the carrying capacity at the channel. Means particular channel, the channel section is, how, what is the channel section here given? 600 by 300. This channel, how much capacity of water it can carry, the meaning conveyance. Have you understood? What is the capacity it can carry, maximum capacity? That is called conveyance. I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
Here, how much water is flowing? 100 liter per second. That is not a capacity of the channel. The water is flowing in a channel 100 liter per second. But how much maximum it can carry or it can convey the
from one place to the other place. That is the conveyance of the channel. Understood? It is
yes,
represented
sir.
As a K is the measure of the carrying capacity of the channel. And for a channel of constant slope, the conveyance is directly proportional to the discharge. Since the bottom slope is a constant, hence it is directly proportional to the channel. So as we know the equation Q equal to AC root of MI. So in this one, the area flow and channel bottom slope and also charges constant C, these all are taken as a constant. I hope you're understanding. These are not changing. Have you understood my question? Hello?
Sir, repeat, sir.
See, here to calculate the conveyance, the area of flow, the bed slope, and the charges constant, whatever the data you have taken, they are being kept constant. They are not changing to calculate the carrying capacity of the channel. When they are kept constant, then the Q is equal to K square root of I, which can be written as a K square root of I. Then where K is this one. K is this one. Understood? Okay. Where K is AC root of M, then the K is called as a conveyance of the channel section. Then the conveyance can, channel section can be calculated as K equal to AC root of M. Here the bottom slope is not taken. Because the bottom slope, why it is not taken? Because the bottom slope is having adjustable bottom slope. It is adjustable, means it is changing. And hence it is not taken here. So K will be AC root of M. Then K equal to AC square root of M. Then substitute here. So this is the capacity of the channel. So if you convert it into liters, how much it is? 3903.9 LPS. But now how much is flowing water in the channel? How much is flowing? We've not taken the problem. Here how much is flowing? 100 liter per second water is flowing. But its capacity to carry is how much? 3903. I hope you understood what is the conveyance.
Yes, sir.
I'll repeat it. Conveyance of the channel section is the measure of the carrying capacity of the channel. And for a channel of constant slope, constant slope, the conveyance is directly proportional to the discharge. See, the directly proportional to the discharge. Then Q equal to, that is Q equal to directly proportional to the conveyance for the constant slope. But kept keeping area of flow, charge is constant, and the hydraulic radius all are constant here, then the K can be taken as K equal to AC root M, because these are the constant. Only I is variable. I cannot be taken here. So it will be AC root of M, hence you'll get the maximum carrying capacity of the channel. That is called as a conveyance. Understood, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So with this three problems, so I'll wind up today's session. If you have any queries, you can ask, and we'll continue in the next class. Next class, we'll take some other shapes of channel section. That is like a trapezium and all. Trapezium, circle. We'll take and solve the problems, and also triangular shape. So we'll solve the problem and practice these kind of problems.